إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله بعثه الله بالهدى ودين الحق لينذر الذين ظلموا وبشرى للمؤمنين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل بدعة ضلالة. In the previous khutbah, we spoke about knowledge, ilm, and the virtue of ilm, and how knowledge is something that makes the path towards Jannah easy, as the Prophet said. مَنْ سَلَكَ طَرِيقًا يَلْتَمِسُ فِيهِ عِلْمًا سَهَلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ بِهِ طَرِيقًا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. And we said that the person who finds themselves occupied in knowledge has a sign from Allah that Allah wants good for that person. Because the Prophet said, مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا. If Allah wants good for a person, يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ. He'll give him understanding in the deen, understanding of the deen. And the scholars of Usul Fiqh in their books have extensively spoken really about what makes a scholar. What are the conditions of a person of knowledge? Maybe 2 years ago or so, I was sat down and I thought to myself, why don't I go through all the verses that mention Ahlul Ilm in the Quran, the people of knowledge, Ulul Ilm, Al Ulama, the scholars, and see in which context they're mentioned in. Maybe we can get a description of what a true scholar is through looking at the verses that talk about ulama. I encourage you to do this yourself. And in fact, I encourage you to do this with any issue that you want to understand. Want to understand the issue of buying and selling? Check out all the verses, and alhamdulillah, computers have made this job much easier for us today. Check out all the verses that talk about buying, selling, trading, and think to yourself, and ponder, what's the sort of attitude that the Qur'an is getting at with all these verses. You start to build a picture of how the Qur'an wants us to approach buying and selling. Look at all the verses that talk about marriage, all the verses that talk about divorce, every verse, and try and read its context, read its background, read any related incidents that were causes of that verse, and you'll come away with a good understanding of how Allah Ta'ala wants us to approach marriage and how Allah Ta'ala wants us to approach divorce. It's a beautiful method. And if you add to that the ahadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that spoke about it, then you'll have no doubt. You'll have an encompassing understanding of how Islam deals with this issue or that issue. So anyway, I said to myself, let me see every ayah that mentions عالم, علماء, أهل العلم, أولو العلم, والراسخون في العلم, those who are firm in ilm. And I noticed that almost every time, the word iman is mentioned alongside it. Or one of the other actions, either iman, either khashya, fear of Allah, either submission. And that made me think really that the true alim that the Qur'an is talking about is not the one who memorizes huge quantities of knowledge, but the person who has essential knowledge acts upon it after that. Essential knowledge, core knowledge, sound knowledge, but then acts upon it after that. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the beginning of Al-Imran mentioned that there are some verses that are متشابهات منه آيات محكمات هن أم الكتاب وأخر متشابهات There are some verses that are open to interpretation. He said, فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ زَيْغٌ, those who have a deviation in their hearts, فَيَتَّبِعُونَ مَا تَشَابَهَ مِنْهِ, they try and seek out these verses that are open to interpretation, leaving the clear verses, leaving the clear teachings, and trying to use these unclear verses or verses that are open to interpretation to justify something that's within themselves. Then he said, وَالرَّاسِخُونَ فِي الْعِلْمِ, as for those who are firm, they have rusukh, firmness and standing in knowledge. وَالرَّاسِخُونَ فِي الْعِلْمِ يَقُولُونَ آمَنَّا بِهِ, as for those who are firm in knowledge, they say, we believe it. We believe everything that Allah comes with. كُلُّ مِنْ عِنْدِ رَبِّنَا, everything's from Allah. So look how soundness in knowledge was proven or manifested through their iman and their submission. In the story of Qarun, إِنَّ قَارُونَ كَانَ مِنْ قَوْمِ مُوسَى, who's biblically known as Korah, and he had huge amounts of wealth, huge amounts of wealth. The Quran describes his wealth in ways that are beyond imagination. Some people were excessively impressed and deceived by how much wealth. يَا لَيْتَلَنَا مِثْلَ مَا أُوْتِيَ قَارُونَ, if only we had the amount of wealth that this guy had. You know how sometimes we talk about wealthy people. Oh, this guy gets £300 a week, this footballer, this player gets £250 a week, I'll just have that once in my life, barakallahu feek. So, Allah Ta'ala is describing people like that who are excessively impressed. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ وَالْإِيمَانِ, as for those who were given ilm and iman. Again, these two words combined together. They were warning them. They said, what is wrong with you? The akhirah is better for you. The akhirah is better for you. Then Allah Ta'ala affirms what they say. تِلْكَ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ نَجْعَلُهَا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فَسَادًا. And so, seeking knowledge and learning knowledge and sitting in gatherings of knowledge and reading and spending time with people of knowledge, that's an important step and it's very essential. And we saw the virtues of that last week, and there is so much more to say about it. But more importantly than that is that knowledge actually has an impact on our hearts, and that is manifested in our firmness upon iman and our submission to Allah and the quality of our ibadah and the quality of our action. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على من لا نبي بعده وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. إنما يخشى الله من عباده العلماء. Another ayah which brings together khashya and ilm, fear of Allah and knowledge. The ones who truly, this is what the ayah says, the ones who truly fear Allah are the ulama. Or it is the ulama, the people of knowledge, who truly fear Allah. They have true fear of Allah. Okay, so that means that if we have excessive information or large amounts of information, but it's having no impact on our action, no impact on our iman, no impact on our fear of Allah, that means that that's not what Allah meant by ulama. That's not what Allah meant by alim, a person of knowledge. And I touched upon this last week, and I want to emphasize it again, that an alim is not necessarily someone who is reading and writing and teaching knowledge as a full-time, daily thing, hours and hours every single day. Not necessarily. Of course, that person is going to benefit from knowledge more than the person who studies less. But the person with a sufficient and respectable amount of sound knowledge that ensures that knowledge shows on his heart, on the condition of his heart, on the condition of his actions, he's 100 times better than the alim who just memorizes or has information in their head. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke in strong terms against someone who says but doesn't act. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لِمَ تَقُولُونَ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ O believers, why do you say that which you don't do? كَبُرَ مَقْتَلْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَن تَقُولُوا مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ It's a great dislike of Allah Ta'ala, with Allah Ta'ala, that you say that which you don't do. And he said, addressing Ahlul Kitab, he said, addressing Bani Israel, أَتَأْبُرُونَ النَّاسَ بِالْبِرِّ وَتَنْسَوْنَ أَنْفُسَكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ تَتْلُونَ الْكِتَابِ Do you command people with piety, bir, and you forget about yourselves, even though you recite the book, وَأَنْتُمْ تَتْلُونَ الْكِتَابِ Meaning, even though you have knowledge, even though you have some prophetic guidance, you do this, that shows that lack of action, and lack of iman, and lack of khashya, contradicts knowledge completely. And this is why, brothers and sisters, we have to combine the issue of spreading knowledge, teaching knowledge, learning knowledge, and setting a good example. Our students, our family members, our community, our children, the thing that they need and the thing that we need most is the good role model. This is why Allah Ta'ala never sufficed with sending a book. There's no such thing as a book just dropping out of the heavens. Bismillah, act upon it. There's no such thing. Because there always needs to be a person to implement and to teach and show the way and be a role model. And this is why to expect our children to grow up upon truth and to grow up with good akhlaq and to grow up reciting the Quran and praying salah on time and not backbiting, keeping their tongues clean. Expecting them to do that because we send them to madrasa, we send them to an Islamic school, or we send them to a weekly class or something. Expecting that to happen, that's a dream. That's a dream. And that's actually one of the things that's harming our society. That on the one side, we hear a lot of talking. Every khutbah is talking. Every dars is talking. Every time we open the phone, there's reminders being circulated. But when we see the quality of our application of this knowledge, young people see almost an element of hypocrisy. We sometimes maybe feel an element of hypocrisy. And so this is why we all, I hope, can start with ourselves in pushing that the little knowledge that we do have, we act upon and apply. And everything else will follow bi-idhnillah. Our children follow bi-idhnillah. Taking these necessary steps though are essential. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purify our hearts and cleanse our hearts from any impurities and any evil desires and any misguidance. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep our hearts firm upon iman. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala nabiyyina Muhammad. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واعف عنا اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم ثبتنا بالقول الثابت في الدنيا والآخرة اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان وانصر أهلنا المظلومين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد